Welcome to this video. In this video, I will show you how you easily and quickly implement an XML transformation SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. Before jumping into the SAP system and creating an XML transformation, I would like to explain you what an XML transformation is. An XML transformation is a conversion of an ABAP structure or ABAP table type into an XML structure. This makes it possible to pack one's desired data in the SAP system into an XML file and process it into a separate system. An XML transformation can thus provide a simple interface since XML is still one of the most widely used data structures today. The abbreviation XML stands for Extensible Markup Language and represents a markup language for the representation of hierarchically structured data. An XML transformation can be mapped into the SAP system in two ways: XSL transformation and simple transformation. The difference lies in the implementation. XSL transformation is based on the XSLT standard. XSLT stands for Extensible Stylesheet Language Transformation. Simple transformation, on the other hand, is SAP's own programming language that also enables the transformation of ABAP data into XML and vice versa. Both options can be used perfectly for XML transformation, SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. You can use an XML transformation in ABAP via the call transformation statement. Using a simple example, I will explain to you how to easily and quickly set up an XML transformation in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. In this example, a purchase order with purchase order header and line item information is packed into an XML structure via an XML transformation and downloaded locally to the computer. The necessary purchase order data is stored in the SAP tables Echo and ECPO. The following steps are executed. So first of all, we're going to create a structure in the ABAP dictionary, so in the transaction code SE11. Then after that, we will create an XML transformation in the transformation editor with a transaction code XSLT_tool or STRANS. Then finally, we're going to create and implement an ABAP program in the ABAP editor in the transaction code SE38. And in here, we are going to select the needed data, and then we are calling our XML transformation, and then finally, we will download this XML file to our local computer. In the transaction code SE11 in the ABAP dictionary, we now create the desired structure. It is possible to use several nodes with the same structure in one XML file. For this, you need a structure that contains a line type. In our example, we just need a structure that contains the header information of the purchase order and as table type, the purchase order items. Keep in mind that a purchase order consists of header information that are saved in the table Echo EKKO and the line item information saved in the table EKPO. So once we have entered the ABAP dictionary, there we select data type, and in here we type in our ID of the table type for the line item information for the ECPO. So I just use set underscore EKPO underscore T, and then I click on create, and here I select table type. Then I click on continue, and in here I'm just simply typing a simple short text. So for example, table type for EKPO. And it is important that for line type, I simply use EKPO, then hit enter, And now I do a syntax check. Yes, save it to my temporary object, so as a local object. And now it has the status new. Then I activate this one. Now it's active and ready for being used. And for the header information, there we create a structure with a field for the line item information. And if we, for example, select database table and then type in EKKO for echo, then we won't use every information in here. I think we just use the most important one. So I just simply select a few of them with the Control Y key combination and then Control C because we need it later on. Then I go one step back and then under data type, I type in set echo underscore echo. I click on create and now I select structure. And in the short description there, I just simply type in structure for EKKO and EKPO as line type, for example. And here I just use Control V to paste in my information. I can use Control Y over here to move it down here to remove the include. So, and now I have jumped a little bit to the front, to the future, because I think you don't have to wait until I have maintained all the components. So here you see I have used a few components of the echo, the header base table. And for this training purpose, I'm not using all of the components, all of the attributes of the echo table. I'm just using a few of them, but here it is quite important that you have a component that describes the line item information, because we are using this information as a node in the XML transformation, and because of that I have just named it ECPO with the table type I have created. So this is quite important that you're using this one. And now I am saving this one. And then I activate it. So, and now you see that this table is activated. If you want to, you can under extras and enhancement category, you can change it to can be enhanced deep if you want to. Okay, now this table is active and can be used in our XML transformation. So here we are right now in the transaction code strans, so strans. If you want to, you can also open up the transformation editor in the transaction code XSLT underscore tool. It doesn't matter because both transaction codes are referring to the exact same ABAP report, to this report to open up the transformation editor. And basically here we are creating the XML transformation. So first of all, we have to type in our ID. So in my case, I'm using set underscore XML underscore ERP underscore up. Then I click on this create button and here I type in a short description. So for example, XML minus transformation ERP up. And under transformation type, there you can decide between two different transformation types, the simple transformation and the XSLT program. And at the beginning of this video, I have explained you the differences between those two types. We are using the simple transformation in this case. Then I click on the save button, and here I want to create this XML transformation as a local object for training purposes. If you want to, you can also link it to a specific package. and transport it to a quality or the productive system. I click on local object. And now we end up in here. Our transformation has been created and saved, but it has still the status inactive. And under source code tab, there we can, if we want to, type in manually the source code for our XML transformation. I recommend to use the graphic editor with this button. You can also change the source code afterward if you want to, but in the source code, if you would type it in manually, then you maybe make some typos, some manual errors, and here you can click on this button, edit simple transformation graphically, or you could also use the key combination Control Shift and F11. Once you've clicked there, here you see basically the root, the default root. Just to tidy it up, I right click and then I delete this root, and then once again I right click and then I insert new root. And here under root name, you can type in the root name that you want to use, but please keep in mind that later on in the ABAP editor, when we would like to create our report, there we have to name our source for this XML transformation, and there we're using this entered root name. So in our case, I just type in purchase underscore order. And under type name, there it is really important that you type in your created ABAP structure in the ABAP dictionary in the transaction code SE11. So for my case, it said echo underscore ECPO. And here you have the chance to select the checkbox line type question mark. And what does this basically do? If you would select this, then you can use this root, this structure multiple times in this XML transformation. And because for our case, I just want to show one specific purchase order, not multiple ones, I don't select this checkbox. Then I click on this OK button, and then we see here our created structure. If I open this up with this dark triangle, then you can see all the fields and also our table type for the purchase or the line items. Then there are two ways to transfer our ABAP structure into the simple transformation. So the first one is you right click and then you select mark data object. Then you move over, once again right click, then you insert mark type, or what I would prefer, that you click on this root and then you drag and drop it in this simple transformation area. And there you can directly see that this structure has been transferred and all the fields are there. Then we are saving our changes. If you want to, you can activate it in here via this button. And then if we're moving one step back, then here in the source code tab, we're seeing that this source code has been created with this wizard quite nicely for us. If we want to, we can make some changes, because in here, these nodes are displayed later on in the XML file. If we want to, we can do it to lower letters if we want to, because by default, all the tags are displayed with upper letters. But for me, that's totally fine. And then we can use this XML transformation. Now, finally, we can use our created XML transformation. For this, I opened up the ABAP editor and the transaction code SE38. And in here, you can create a new ABAP report by typing in the program name. Keep in mind that it has to start with the Y or Z letter at the beginning, or your specific company namespace. And then you can click on create, set up the title, set it up as an executable program. I have already done this because now I'm going into the change mode to show you the changes I have done. And what are you currently doing in the program? What can you do? So basically, in here, we are basically selecting the needed data from the tables, so the echo. I'm transferring all the fields into my structure. Because of that, I had just copied a few of the fields of them. Then I'm doing the exact same for the purchase or the line items for the ECPO in this table. And then I am executing our XML transformation. As explained some couple of seconds ago, here you have to name your specific root name. So once again, we can open up the strans in a new window, display or transformation. And in here, this root name is quite important, or you also see it right there. And this is the name that you have to use in this source. So here you're linking your data to the source, and then you want to write your results in this structure as a string in this case. And then what we are doing is that we are concatenating the specific path file to a variable, to this file name, and then we are downloading this XML file. So I think the most important statement is this one, and before this, the selection of the data. What do you want to? You can afterwards maybe do another task, but this is just a sample program that you can use, that you can enhance and change if you want to. So then I execute this report with the direct processing button, or you could also hit the F8 key on your keyboard. And then right here, I type in a specific purchase order number, so this one in this case, and a specific path where I would like to download my specific XML file. And then if I execute this report, then you see that the file has been downloaded. And if I open this up, then here you see the data that has been downloaded, and you can analyze it, you can maybe format it, but this is a way how you can parse data from an ABAP structure to an XML structure. You don't have to copy this code manually. So basically, on my German-speaking SAP blog, I put the link in the video description. There you can copy this code with this copy to clipboard button. There you have to be careful to change the source attribute to your specific root name. Maybe you can change some specific translations and keyword, but this is basically a sample that you can use. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and learned a lot about the XML transformation in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. Hit the like button, add a comment, and subscribe for free, and then see you in the next video.